What are complex numbers and what are its properties? So, complex number is the superset. If A and B, these are two real numbers, then a number of the form A plus IB, this is called a complex number. It is called a complex number. For example, 7 plus 2i. Now, this is a complex number. We write it as Z. Z is represented for the complex number here. And this part is called the real part, say real part of Z. And this part, RE, we write, RE. And this part, this 2, it includes the sign also. And this is called the imaginary part. We write it as IM of Z. So we have a purely real and purely imaginary complex number also. For example, if the imaginary part is 0, imaginary part of some Z is 0, that is in A plus IB, if this imaginary part is 0, this part is 0, B is 0, so we have purely, only A is there, so this is purely real complex number. If in this A plus IB, we have the real part as 0, this is 0, that means this A is 0, so only imaginary part will be there. So this will be purely imaginary complex number. So how do we write this in the set form? We write C as for complex. This C is for representing any complex number, we use Z. But this Z is also used for what? For integers. So for writing it as a set, we write C. And this is written as A plus IB colon, where A and B belong to real number. Right? So, real number is basically a subset of C, because every real number, say if A, this can be written as a complex number, how? A plus I into 0. So, every real number can be written as a complex number. So, real number is a subset of complex number. When we say the equality of complex number, what do we mean? If say we have Z1 as A1 plus IB1 and Z2 as A2 plus IB2. What does it mean when we say Z1 is equal to Z2? That means A1 has to be equal to A2 and B1 has to be equal to B2. I'll take an example. If Z1 equal to 2 minus IY and Z2 is equal to X plus 3I, then you have to find out the value of X and Y when Z1 is equal to Z2. So if you see is X is equal to 2, X is equal to 2 because the real part has to be equal and the imaginary part has to be equal. So y will be equal to what? This minus y will be equal to 3. So y will be equal to minus 3. So this is equality of complex number. When we talk about addition, addition of complex number, that is the real part will be added with real part and imaginary part will be added with the imaginary part. I'll take an example. So if z1 is equal to 2 plus 3i, and Z2 is equal to 3 minus 2i. So if you want to add them, so add the real part. So Z will be, that is Z1 plus Z2. Z will be 2 plus 3 plus I. And the imaginary part you add along with the sign. So 3 plus, this is, let me take it as minus so that you understand well. We have to take the sign, okay? So 3 minus 2. So it will be 5. Plus 3 minus 2 is 1, so I. This will be the result. So what are the properties of addition of complex number? Let us see here. The properties of addition of complex number. Addition is commutative. That means Z1 plus Z2 will be equal to Z2 plus Z1. Addition is associative. What does it mean? Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3. Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 will remain same. If you add these two first and add this with Z3, or if you add Z2 and Z3 and add this with Z1. So this is associative. There is an existing of additive identity. That means if you add Z with something, it has to come as 0, as Z. So this 0 is the additive identity. So how do we write 0 in complex form? We have 0 plus I0. So this is the additive identity. Then we have existence of additive inverse. Inverse. So this is identity and this is inverse. What does it mean? If you have Z equal to say A plus IB, then the minus Z is the additive identity, additive inverse of this one. That is minus A minus IB. This is the additive inverse. So additive inverse, when you add Z and minus Z, it has to, if you add these two, it has to be zero. So this is how it is obtained or defined. Then the subtraction. Subtraction of complex number. So if Z1 is say minus 2 plus 3i, and I'll take an example. Z2 is 4 plus 5i. So Z1 minus Z2, that is Z1 minus Z2 will be this minus this. So real part minus real part. So minus 2 minus 4. You're subtracting it. Plus this 3 minus 5i. So this will be minus 6 and this will be minus 2i. Z1 minus Z2. Now coming to the multiplication. Multiplication of complex number. Z1, Z2. Let us write it as A1 plus IB1. And this one as A2 plus IB2. Now multiply A1, A2. This will be I, right? Plus A1, B2. Then this one. Plus I, B1, A2. Now this one. So, I square and B1, B2. And we know for the complex number, I square is equal to minus 1. So, this will be minus 1. So let us write it as minus. Now take these two together. It will be A1, A2 minus B1, B2. And then take I common from these two. You get I, A1, B2 plus B1, A2. This is the multiplication. So you can use the direct formula also. So what are the properties of multiplication? Multiplication is commutative. That means Z1, Z2 in complex term is equal to Z2, Z1. It is associative as well. That means Z1, Z2, Z3, if you multiply these three, Z1, Z2, Z3, this means if you multiply these two and multiply with Z3, or if you multiply these two and multiply with Z1, this will be same. Then we have existence of identity element of multiplication. So identity element, that is if you multiply Z with something, it should come Z. So it is 1. And how do we write 1? It is 1 plus I into 0. In complex, we write like this. Then we have existence of multiplicative inverse. That is, if you multiply Z with something, it should come 1. So this we write as Z1. Write it as Z1. So multiplicative inverse, let me just take an example. You write it as the Z1 is nothing but 1 by Z. So you can write it as 1 by Z or Z inverse. So how to get this Z inverse? Let us take an example. Then you understand. So, Z is 3 minus 2i. Or let me prove it, then I'll just use this to find out the value. So, if you have say Z into Z1 equal to 1, let us take Z as A plus IB and this Z1 as X plus IY. And as I said, it has to come as 1. 1 can be written as 1 plus I0. Now, multiply these two. Multiply these two, you know, this will be AX. I just told you how to multiply this. AX minus BY plus I into AY plus BX. Just multiply this, nothing else. Do 1 plus I into 0. Now equate the real and imaginary part. So AX minus BY will be equal to 1 and AY plus BX will be equal to 0. So when you solve it, X will come as A by A square plus B square and Y will come as minus B by A square plus B square. So this Z is nothing but this X plus IY. So I'll just show you how we solve it. If Z is 3 minus 2Y, as I said, Z inverse we have to find out. So it will be A by A square plus B square. A is what? 3. 3 by A, this is B, this is. So 3 square plus minus 2 whole square plus I. Now you have to write minus here, minus B. So minus B, what is minus B? This is b is minus 2. So, minus of minus 2 by a square plus b square. Again, this one. 3 square plus minus 2 whole square. So, what do you get? 3 by 3 square is 9 and this is 2 to the 4 plus 4. So, 13. Minus minus become plus. So, it will be plus I. Again, this will be 13. So, 1 by 13. So, this is it. This is your Z inverse. Okay, this is the multiplicative properties. Now coming to the division of complex number. Division of complex number. So whenever you have Z1 by Z2, you can write it as Z1 by Z2 inverse. Z2 inverse you can take it, or you can just write it as Z1 into 1 by Z. This also you can write. So this is we can just use the formula also. Like if I take Z1 as 2 plus 3i and Z2 as say 1 plus 2i. So, Z1 by Z2 is nothing but 2 plus 3i by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 2i. And I told you this 1 by 2i, this Z inverse of this is by this formula. Okay, Z inverse by using this formula A by A square plus B square plus I minus B by A square plus B square. So, I am using direct formula for this 1 plus 2i, 2 plus 3i. I am just using the formula for this. So, this will become, if you use it, 1 by 5 minus 2 by 5i. Now, just multiply it. You will get it as 8 by 5 minus 1 by 5i. Now, coming to the conjugate of complex number. Conjugate is what? You represent Z as A plus IB. So, conjugate is defined by Z bar. And it is nothing but A minus IB. You just have to change the sign here. Just change the sign here. It will be A minus IB. For example, if Z is 3 plus 4i, so Z inverse will be 3 minus 4i. So there are certain properties of conjugate. If you take Z bar of bar, you will get Z. If you take Z and Z bar add, you will get twice of real part of Z. If you subtract them, Z minus Z bar, you will get twice of I, then imaginary part of Z. If Z is equal to Z bar, that means it implies Z is purely real. If Z plus Z bar is equal to 0, that means Z is purely imaginary. If Z dot Z bar, if you multiply them, you will just get real part of Z whole square plus imaginary part of Z whole square. Z1 plus Z2 whole bar is equal to Z1 bar plus Z2 bar. So, these are the property of conjugate. Also, Z1 minus Z bar, Z1 minus Z2 whole bar is nothing but Z1 bar minus Z2 bar. If you multiply it, Z1 dot Z2 bar, it is Z1 bar, Z2 bar. So, if you take Z1 by Z2 whole bar, it will be Z1 bar by Z2 bar. But Z2 should not be equal to 0. So, these are the properties of conjugate. Coming to the modulus of a complex number, modulus. So, modulus is represented by mod of Z. So, mod of Z equal to A plus IB is simply under root of the real part A square plus the imaginary part B square. So, this is your modulus, right? For example, if I want to take the modulus of 3 minus 4i, what this will be? Under root 3 square, that is a square plus this b square. So, you will get as 3, 9, 4, 4 is 16 under root. This is going to be 5. So, this is the modulus of complex number. So, there are certain properties of modulus of a complex number. That is, if mod z is equal to 0, this implies that z is equal to 0. That is, real part is also 0. And imaginary part is also 0. The mod of Z, if it is equal to mod of Z bar, so that means it is equal to minus Z. Bar means minus Z and then the modulus. Z into Z bar is nothing but mod of Z whole square. You take Z1, Z2 and then you take the modulus, you will get it as the Z1 separately and Z2 separately modulus. Then we have Z1 by Z2. Divide them and take modulus. You will get like this Z1 modulus and Z2 modulus. Also, if you have Z1 plus Z2 whole square, that is going to be Z1 whole square, Z1 modulus whole square plus Z2 modulus whole square plus 2 real part of Z1 Z2 bar. Okay. If you take Z1 minus Z2 and then take the modulus and square, it will be Z1 modulus square plus Z2 modulus square minus 2 real part of Z1 dot Z2 bar. Then if you add these two, that means these two if you add, you will simply get, if you see here, twice of Z1 square plus twice of Z2 square, and this gets cancelled. So these are the properties of the modulus. There is one more property. If you take A, Z1, some constant A, minus B, Z2, and then take modulus and then take square and add it with B, Z1. Now B comes here. So B, Z1 plus A comes here, A, Z2 and square. You will get it as A square plus B square, and then inside this you have Z1 modulus square plus Z2 modulus square. So these are the properties of the modulus of a complex number. Then we have reciprocal of a complex number. What is the reciprocal of a complex number? We have already seen this. You have already seen this, the reciprocal of a complex number. So reciprocal is simply, for Z, reciprocal is 1 by Z. And I told you how to get this. We have already the formula. Now I'll show you how to get this formula in another way. So this 1 by Z can be written as 1 by A plus IB, because A plus IB is Z. Now multiply numerator and denominator by A minus IB. That is the conjugate. A minus IB. So this is A minus IB. But see, this is X plus Y, X minus Y. So this will be X square minus Y square. So A square minus I square, B square. So this A square, one, this I square will be minus 1. A square will be, I square will be 1 minus 1. Minus 1 minus 1 is minus 1 minus 1 and minus is plus. So A square plus B square. So what do you get? A minus IB. Now separate them. It will be A by A square plus B square minus IB by A square plus B square. So this is how we got the previous thing also. But now here it is by this method. So 1 by Z is this one. A minus IB by A square plus B square. You can write it as Z bar by the conjugate and then this modulus square. So you can write it like this also. So this is a way of expressing the reciprocal of a complex number. So these are the properties of a complex number, and you will understand it better and more when we will take the actual example in the exercise. Okay. So this is all, and we have to see after this, there are certain things which we are going to see, that is the how to represent them in this graph, and also the square root. This we are going to see in the later discussion. So till now, it's the properties we have seen. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.